In the past, you might have heard me say something like this.
It doesn't have to be fancy. It doesn't have to be someone else's written opinion.
Or perhaps you remember me saying this. Go out, burn your recipes, and cook from your heart with an artistic endeavor. I think I've become pretty well known for this. Recipes are intimidating. Recipes are confusing. This is the biggest problem for the home cook. It's not cooking, it's following recipes. So a chef who talks about burn your recipes, don't cook by recipes, is that to say that I don't have a single cookbook? Well, certainly not. I have cookbooks. I don't have many recipe books. And the distinction in my mind is different. A cookbook will actually teach you how to cook. We'll have methods of cooking. A recipe book has a list of instructions for you to follow without telling you what the underlying method is. So you get the idea. Yeah, I have cookbooks and I have my favorite cookbooks, but I have very few recipe books. So a guy that talks about burning your recipes all the time, what kind of cookbooks do I have? Let me show you. This is my cookbook cabinet up here. First and foremost, in the way of recipe books, and you've seen me talk about it before, Food Lover's Companion. There's not a recipe in here. This is like a dictionary of food. So when you go to a restaurant and there's a mussels bolognese in there, you'd be able to look it up in here. If you go to a really fancy French restaurant, then you might want Le Repertoire de Cuisine. No recipes again, but it tells you combinations of things. When I look at filet mignon, Alsace filet mignon is grilled, dish on croutons, garnished with sauerkraut and bacon. I mean, it just tells you what it is. So these reference books are my favorite books in the kitchen. Next, on cooking. This was my textbook in culinary school, and it is a textbook of cooking. Yes, there are recipes in here, but the recipes demonstrate the procedures, and this book is broken up into different cooking methods and ways to cook ingredients rather than just an incredible unending list of recipes. It tells you how to do it. This is what I like about cookbook versus recipe book. When I get around to baking, professional baking. This was a textbook in culinary school also, but the thing that I really like about this is the formulas in here, and again, they're formulas, not recipes. They're all done by weight. It's a lot easier to bake by weight than it is by quarter cup, half cup, especially European measurements make it a little bit easier, but the American, English, imperial measurements make baking a nightmare. That's got everything weighed for you by weight. And then some of my favorite cookbooks are things that are very specific, whether they're regional or a specific type of cooking. I have very few just Rachel Ray How to Cook books. I mean, I can come up with the same ideas Rachel Ray does. I mean, so can you for that matter. But things like An American Place. This is a history of American food. It's by Larry Forgione, and I actually met him, and my copy is signed, I think. There he is. Ha-ha. So this is specialty American food, and speaking of which, one of my other favorite cookbooks is the Williamsburg Cookbook. This is real old-timey stuff, and if you wanted to cook in a certain method, this is the way they cooked way back when Williamsburg, Virginia was. Williamsburg Cookbook. Or things like Celebrate San Antonio. I might want Southwestern cooking. Tropic cooking is specific when I want Caribbean cuisines, things like that. Here's another great one that is a reference book, not a cookbook, The Flavor Bible. Karen Page and Andrew Dornenberg. The Flavor Bible goes over herbs, spices, flavors, all kinds of ingredients and what they go with. Not much recipe in there, but knowledge for you to create recipes from. Along the same vein, my New Orleans cookbook. You get the idea? I mean, there are recipes in there as well, but it's not how to make a grilled cheese sandwich. It is how to cook in a specific method. So, of all these cookbooks, what's my number one cookbook? What's my favorite? What's the greatest cookbook? Let me show you this. Well, second favorite. When I started going to culinary school, I started a composition notebook, and every recipe that I made up that came to mind, I started writing down in this composition notebook. Because I'm cooking without recipes, I'm discovering new things all the time, and I now have two of these composition books full of original recipes, 100 sheets each. That's 200 original recipes. And I say it in our cooking course. How many have I made twice? Not a single one. Now the prize, the creme de la resistance, or however they say it. This is my grandmother's cookbook. My 102-year-old grandmother, who just passed this year. This cookbook from 1921, handwritten by her. She was 14 years old in school at the time. And this is food history to me. The things that they use, you see fatback in here. You see lard and bacon rendering and soured milk. There's a recipe in here for souring your milk with vinegar. So when you learn to cook without recipes by basic cooking methods, the types of cookbooks, not recipe books, the types of cookbooks you choose will change, because you'll be interested in styles of cooking, in types of cooking, not just searching for another way to make macaroni and cheese. I'm hoping that you can come up with your own Rachel Ray macaroni and cheese. For me and you, I'd rather get inspirations from recipes. I'd rather get ideas from recipes and then make them my own by changing the cooking method, changing the ingredients, anything that I'd like. But you'll see that the cookbooks that I have are very narrowly focused, because I want to put my interpretation in on them.